if someone goes out and uses the firearm to illegally poach an animal. There's a spent casing, which can be evidence. We had Benny search for those casings in some very tall grass. When he finds a casing, he'll lay down with the casing between his two front paws, and he'll basically put his nose right on it. Dogs are an effective tool at finding wildlife because of their incredible sense of smell and their incredible natural hunting behavior. They can basically see the unseen for us. Wildlife trafficking is happening everywhere where somebody thinks that they can make some sort of profit off of wildlife or natural resources. Many people automatically assume it's a problem in Africa, it's a problem in Asia, especially those of us in North America, we automatically think it's not our problem. Wildlife trafficking is happening all over the world. There's definitely the concern with wildlife trafficking pushing these species to the brink of extinction, but there's a much bigger picture to it that people don't often think about. When you think of it on a larger scale, it's often tied to other crimes, trafficking in weapons, trafficking in humans. So a lot of this is tied together.
A dog is able to smell a teaspoon of sugar dissolved into the amount of water that would fill two Olympic swimming pools. So that's kind of the level of specificity that they're able to get down to, which is just absolutely incredible. And when you compare dogs to human searchers, they're consistently faster, they cover more ground, and they're often more accurate.
What makes dogs so exceptional at this job is their olfactory ability and their ability to hunt out those odors and the ability for us to work with them. They're very trainable. They want to do a good job. They want the reward. And so we use the reward to help show them what we want them to find. You can see that he very much loves and wants his ball.
We are at the Working Dogs for Conservation World headquarters. It's 45-ish acres just outside of Missoula, Montana. We're the world's foremost conservation detection dog organization. So what we do is we take primarily rescue dogs. We look for absolutely ball crazy, high energy, confident rescue dogs that need a job, need something to do, and then we train them. And then we put them to work protecting wildlife and wild places by searching for endangered species, invasive species, and things related to wildlife crime. We have a whole bunch of different scents that the dogs have been trained to do. So that ranges everything from spotted cat skins. So a lot of our dogs in Africa, that's a pretty common contraband item. Ivory, rhino horn, shark fin, ammo, and guns.
I was in wildlife law enforcement for 11 years. The past three of those years was as a detective with the Washington Department of Fish and Wildlife Police. And as part of that, I had canine Benny. I found him when he was right around 1.5. He was evaluated as a working dog. He passed the initial evaluation. Then we went through a few months of training. He did very well with that. And about a year or so ago, we made the transition to Working Dogs for Conservation. And since then, Benny is being trained on more conservation-related target odors.
My dog Barley is a 6.5-year-old border collie. He is in the process of learning both shark fin and ivory. When I'm training Barley, we're generally working with buckets or PVC pipes so that there's a lot of different containers that have different things in them, and he learns that what he's supposed to do is tell me about a given scent. One of the really cool things about using detection dogs is that you can use them at multiple stages along the pipeline of wildlife crime. So dogs are able to search vehicles as the vehicles are coming into the park, where they might find ammunition or guns that let us know that those people were not coming into the park for the right reasons. They also are able to, in some cases, track the animals and actually make sure the animals are healthy. We've had dogs that are trained to track specific animals, so a specific rhino, and make sure that rhino is doing well. Then if there is a poaching event that occurs, we can use the dogs to track backwards and hopefully make an arrest before that contraband ever makes it to market. The dogs can also be used to intercept contraband in the example of searching a vehicle or searching a shipping container and intercepting that ivory or shark fin before it's ever actually able to be sold. My previous job before this was working with dogs that were deemed unadoptable at shelters due to behavior issues. Working with these high energy, ball crazy, high drive dogs is where shelters really struggle the most. We're not just giving these dogs a home, we're not just rescuing them, we're actually able to put exactly what made them a bad pet and put that to use, protecting other wildlife, wild places. It's so special and it's what really gets me excited to come to this job every day.
The work we do at WD4C has multiple impacts, saving and protecting natural resources and helping end wildlife crime. There's also the impact of us giving dogs second chances, going into shelters and finding dogs that need jobs and need new homes and need a purpose. And we're able to do both of those things.